September 2019. Hurricane Dorian roars ashore on Great Abaco Island, the Bahamas. Sustained winds of 185 miles per hour and gusts to 220. Super Typhoon Mawar's winds hit 180, gusting over 200 miles per hour. Homes on Guam destroyed, the island left without power. It's the strongest Northern Hemisphere tropical cyclone on record in the month of May. Strong hurricanes are becoming more common, and they're likely to get even more destructive as the climate warms. So how bad could they get? Hi, my name is Alexandra Steele. I'm a meteorologist and climate communication specialist. In this series about the wild world of extreme weather, I'll be introducing you to scientists, experts, and some of my friends who are all leaders in the field of weather and climate to share stories, ideas, and insights, and even learn a few things along the way. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. So, to find out how bad these hurricanes could get, we first need to understand exactly what climate change is doing to these tropical beasts. Carbon pollution from our cars, homes, and power plants is blanketing the planet, warming the atmosphere and oceans, and the increased heat is fueling stronger and longer-lasting storms. Jeff Masters is a meteorologist, a former hurricane hunter, and has been studying the weather and climate for decades.
For every degree centigrade you warm the oceans, you put about 7% more moisture in the atmosphere. That means your rains that you get from any storm, not just a hurricane, we can expect to be, 7% more. But actually, it turns out that you could get something even larger than that effect, because as you put more heat energy into a storm, more moisture, when that moisture condenses, it releases the heat that it took to evaporate it in the first place, which energizes the storm, makes it bigger, helps it bring in even more moisture and more energy from further away, thus intensifying the storm even more and helping it drop more precipitation.
Hurricanes are getting stronger, slower, and more devastating, with higher winds, slower speeds, and heavier, longer-lasting rainfall. Flooding is no longer only a coastal concern. Susan Joy Hassol is a climate change communicator, analyst, and author who's been studying the climate for 30 years, and actually quite famous for training scientists how to swap geek speak for street speak.
We are now seeing stronger storms. They're intensifying more rapidly. They're moving more slowly. They're dumping more rainfall. The storm surges are higher. We have to convey all of that. We have to let people know why that's happening. Because if we're not connecting those dots, then people aren't really understanding the why of how this threat is changing. It's especially challenging in areas where people are not used to seeing hurricanes. They think, well, that's not my problem. That's something for the coast. So we have to let them know that these things are changing and why they're changing.
To boost awareness, one option could be to modify the Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Wind Scale. It's a decades-old way of communicating a hurricane's strength that uses average wind speeds to estimate potential property damage on a scale of 1 to 5. At Category 1, winds are from 74 to 95 miles per hour with minimal damage, down trees and power lines. At the other end of the scale, at Category 5, a hurricane is catastrophic, with sustained winds at a minimum of 157 miles per hour. In a Cat 5 hurricane, most homes would be destroyed, creating uninhabitable conditions for months. The scale was developed in 1971 by Herbert Saffir, a civil engineer, and Robert Simpson, a meteorologist and director of the National Hurricane Center at the time, and they capped the scale at Cat 5. But with global warming creating stronger, slower, and more devastating hurricanes, should a Category 6 or even a 7 be added?
We can already say that we're getting what are equivalent to Category 6 hurricanes. Because if you extend the Saffir-Simpson scale, about every 20 miles per hour in sustained winds, it goes up a category. Right now, 160 mile per hour winds and higher is a Category 5, and it's an open-ended scale. There's nothing higher than that. But if you wanted to extend it, you know, it would be logical to say that, say, at 180, 185 mile per hour winds, that would be a Category 6 storm. And we've already seen Super Typhoon Mawar, which hit Guam, had 185 mile per hour sustained winds after it hit the island, fortunately. That would really rank as a Category 6 hurricane. So the only question really is, do we want to start calling them that? Does it make sense?
Or should these new stronger storms be classified in a different way? The biggest threat to life and property from a hurricane is storm surge and flooding. The biggest killer in any hurricane is not the wind, it's the water.
We don't have something that corresponds to the amount of rainfall or flooding a storm can bring, because back in 2017 when Hurricane Harvey hit, I mean, that dumped a record amount of precipitation, over 50 inches in parts of Texas. And yet most of that rain fell while it was just a tropical storm stalled inland. Yeah, we need to have a better way to communicate the flood risk from a hurricane.
That flooding from both storm surge and rainfall is the deadliest aspect. What I think is maybe more important than changing the scale, it's very difficult to change a scale that people have come to know. And also, Category 5 hurricanes are relatively rare. Landfalling Cat 5 hurricanes in the US, there's only a handful of them. So I don't know that we need to change that scale, but I think we need to add something new that's about the flooding threat. And maybe something simple like yellow, orange, or red alert for flooding to be added to whatever the category for the wind speed is might be a good way to go.
If the Saffir-Simpson wind scale were to be changed, there's only one entity that can do it.
The National Hurricane Center would be the ones to make that call. And currently, they're not wanting to do that because from a warning standpoint, which is what they do, they provide hurricane warnings, a Category 5 hurricane's already catastrophic. So you don't really add anything to say, hey, you know, there's a Category 6 hurricane coming your way. You're going to get out of the way of a Category 5. At least I hope you would. So it's not going to happen from their perspective. From a climate change perspective, maybe it makes sense to start labeling them as such because it draws attention to the fact that, hey, you know, super intense hurricanes are now more possible than they used to be.
Times have changed. The climate has also changed. It's warmer, it's wetter, and hurricanes are stronger, slower, and more destructive. And we've changed too. Building codes have changed. The population has grown and changed. Where we live has changed. We have moved and migrated, wanting to be near the coast and in the south, putting millions more in the path of incoming tropical storms and hurricanes. So what does the future hold? Is this new, stronger, slower breed of hurricane becoming the norm?
What you see now is not what you're going to get in a few years. It's going to continue accelerating these extreme events, and it's going to be very crazy.
When we say new normal, it almost sounds like we've reached a new steady state and this is the way it's going to be. But in fact, it's going to keep getting worse until we zero out our emissions. So it's not a new normal, it's a new abnormal, and it's going to keep getting worse. This is only the beginning. This is with 1.1 degrees Celsius of warming. Wait till you see it at 1.5. And that's the best case, is that we'll be able to limit it to 1.5. So this is going to keep getting worse until we eliminate that heat trapping pollution. And then it's going to level off. We're not going to get to go back to our grandparents' climate.
One modeling study that I was looking at, which modeled essentially Category 6 hurricanes, ones of 190 miles per hour or greater, it showed that by the end of the century, we could see a factor of 8 increase in those type of ultra-extreme hurricanes. Those are a big concern because for every Saffir-Simpson category you go up, you get about a factor of 8 increase in damage. So if we start getting these super typhoon Haiyan-like storms with 190 mile per hour winds, that's gonna cause a big burden on society because the amount of devastation those incredibly intense Category 6 storms will just be mind-boggling.
As the climate warms, we can expect stronger and more destructive hurricanes. Regardless of what we call them, we should expect them. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to give it a like and subscribe to our channel. And for more climate change coverage, visit our website at climateconnections.org.